layoff as a they usually happen like twice or thrice a year, and there's for internships for mathematical finance, there's like specific companies who come there every year. It's like more like a campus recruiting kind of thing. So there's like Charles River Development, State Street, McKinsey, and I think a couple of others. They come in every year. But there's like four or five companies which definitely come there and give internships to at least 20, 30 students out of 100. But the others, like you try to find through career fairs which are held, but I didn't find that very helpful. So I think the most helpful, other than the those companies that come in, was LinkedIn. And I think that's like the most popular tool even now, looking for full-time or internships. You just connect with people, find jobs over there. LinkedIn is the one tool that you should use. You can connect with people, with your alumni, and even if you don't want to, you can just look at jobs and try to apply to them. Like, don't try to do a little bit of everything. Just try to focus on two things. If you're trying to get an asset management internship, just try to focus on that. And just try to focus on two things and spot everything. There's a lot of people who make this mistake of trying to find each and every internship possible. They do get interviews, but then they're not able to clear those. So I would say just focus on one or two different things that you want to apply to, and then just apply to those companies. They help you with like your resume and interview preparation and stuff, but in terms of like actually connecting you to people, they are not very good. So it's anywhere between $15 to $50 an hour. They'll typically ask you questions on what you've done and what your interests are. So they won't ask you questions that are out of your knowledge bank or anything like that. They only ask you on your competencies. For full-time jobs, there's one career fair which my university, Boston University, takes students to. It's like the biggest career fair for quantitative finance, or it's like for financial engineering, mathematical finance. Like everyone goes to New York, they take you there, and it's quite a decent career fair where most of these companies looking for quant students and freshers, they would come in and you can talk to them. So that is one career fair which is very important. Like almost all the financial engineering students go there, so it's like not the easiest too, but I think a lot of recruiting happens from there. It's like career fairs and LinkedIn is still the same what I did. For any kind of job opportunity, whether it's a full-time, part-time, internship, I would say those are like the best sources that you have. There's nothing different in terms of your go-to place. Depends on what kind of client job you have, so that you can focus that on your resume and show them, hey, I have these kind of skills to my entire job. So that will definitely help. People do get jobs late, but I don't think I've seen anyone go back home because they do not get a job or something like that. So I think most of them find something. $1,000 to $120,000. Sponsorship does play a role, but if you apply to the bigger companies, I don't think they care about sponsorship or not sponsoring the visa. So unless you are in a 2-3 people startup, which I don't think quant finance graduates are required in those kind of positions.